According to a respected religious rights organization, the Christian population of Syria's third largest city has dropped from around 55,000 to less than 1,000. Barnabas Aid links a mass migration from Homs to strife between the troops of President Assad and anti-government forces. The report goes on to say, during the worst of the conflict, the opposition forces attacked churches and also occupied an evangelical school and home for the elderly, which were then shelled by the army. Church leaders have reported that Muslim neighbors are turning on the Christians and that Muslim extremists from other countries have been coming to Homs to join the fighting. This must be exposed and stopped. But beyond Homs, Barack Obama and many in the media continue to portray the uprisings throughout the Middle East as freedom fighters. In reality, they are often sects of radical Islam overthrowing existing, sometimes more moderate regimes. Barnabas Aid tells us Christians have also suffered kidnappings and gruesome murders. Some Christian families, unable to pay a ransom for their relatives' release and fearing that they may be tortured, have been driven to ask the kidnappers to kill their loved ones at once. Yet the reported plight is ignored by the media, UN, and the Obama administration. How many more innocent Christian families will eventually be slaughtered in what appears to be imminent U.S.-backed genocide? And how does one reconcile Obama's wholesale abandonment of the Christian community in Muslim countries with his dropping of all state business to fawn all over Trayvon Martin? And how, if he had a son, he'd look like Trayvon? What will it take for the world to wake up and realize that Barack Obama is apparently working at breakneck speed to help the most radical Islamic regimes eradicate Christianity and take over the Middle East? And perhaps the world.